that you catch a little bit of hell from people now when you tweet. You're tweeting about all kinds of stuff. But you've always tweeted about everything. Why are people suddenly saying, you know, hey, why are you doing this? Why are they criticizing?
You know what I find the most interesting is I think there's such an opportunity, like in social media, like there's such an opportunity within it to have discussions. Like, and you know, I'm an American citizen, so I have 4 children. I have to explain a lot of things daily.
Right.
Yeah.
Right.
And with the news. So, you know, it's like one of those things where I feel like, and that's why I always try and respond as a positive human would. I always try and be like, look, it's cool we don't agree, but like, at the end of the day, you're not going to get anywhere just being hateful. Like, you know, so just like, feel, and like we can find common ground. I'm sure of it. So
well, the operative word is I am an American citizen.
I know, it's so silly, right? When they say the whole celebrity thing, like you shouldn't. And I literally, when I voted this year, I had a woman in line with me, and we were, you know, going down the line just talking about kids and stuff. And then right before we went in to vote, you're not allowed to talk, you know. And she asked me, she goes, so what is your take on like celebrities having an opinion about anything?
She said that.
I was like, wow, we had so much in common for like 2 hours. And then it just like, I was like, what? I was like, well, I feel like I'm a human and I'm an American citizen, so I should, right? Like, what? I was like.
Well, you know, Hillary Clinton gave you a shout out in her book.
In her book. I was like, okay.
And she said, this is what she wrote. She said, that which does not kill us makes us stronger, which is Friedrich Nietzsche's statement. She
both
said,
philosophers.
But she quoted Friedrich Nietzsche and Kelly Clarkson. Yeah. So.
I thought it was cool too, because you know, like all the flack, like regardless if you like or if you don't, if you voted for or didn't, whatever, but it's just all the flack. There's a lot of pressure when you're in the public eye, regardless if you're in politics, you're a celebrity, whatever it is. And I thought it was lighthearted to start a book off like that. I thought it was like, you know, some famous philosopher and then being like, and also Kelly Clarkson. So it shows a little humor, and I thought it was cool. Yeah.
Well, you have been in the public eye since you were 19. I just realized. And we talk a lot about Harvey Weinstein and a lot of women that have been coming forward now and standing up to these men. You've been standing up to strong men in your career since you were 19. What advice do you have to young girls that may be struggling?
You know what? I mean, I'm just going to keep it real. I say open discussion. I say, okay, if you feel comfortable saying that to me, I'm just going to feel comfortable saying it, what you said. Mm-hmm. Like, so I think that's why a lot of people, like, you know, behind closed doors, I don't think people thought that I was ever going to say anything.
Yeah.
And they thought they were going to get away with it. I've never been in a situation like the Weinstein thing, mm-hmm. but I just mean like in a sexist way or a belittling way because I'm young and mm-hmm. and just demeaning, you know? And I think I'll call it out. Like, if somebody asks me a question, I'm not going to lie for you.
Right.
I'm not going to guise it for you. Like, I think that's the best thing to do, is not like you're attacking someone, just telling your honest story. Mm-hmm. And I don't know. I think that we have to respect that and validate that, like, whatever that is for each individual.
Yeah. And tell your own truth when you're just starting out.
You have to tell your truth. You have to be honest. Or you're not going to. I have a lot of friends that, unfortunately, had horrific things happen in their childhood, and it damaged them for quite a long time mm-hmm. because they felt like they couldn't say anything. And I don't think people realize the weight and the gravity that takes on a person and how to handle it. Mm-hmm. So you have to be honest about it for you to heal, you know, so.
I like that.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, 100%. You have your new 8th studio album coming out called Meaning of Life. Amazing. Thank you for the women of the world. Every bad breakup I've ever gone through, it's only your music on repeat. But tell me about this new album and this new chapter in your life.
You know, actually, the last time I was here, I was telling you, I was like, it's going to be more soulful. It's definitely more soulful pop vibe, but I think it's really what people thought was going to happen whenever I was on Idol. Like, all I did was sing Aretha Franklin or, like, you know, that kind of old school soulful pop. And I wanted to make a record that was 2017 version of that. You know, I didn't want a time capsule sound, but I wanted something contemporary that had that vibe, because those are the singers that made me want to be a singer. Mm-hmm. And I felt like I waited long enough to make the album, be able to make it. So I'm super proud of it, and I'm so glad that, like, everyone's digging it, because there's nothing worse than, like, you loving something so much, never to be like, meh, meh.
Kelly, you have two young kids, three-year-old River, who we're going to talk about in a minute, but also one-year-old Remy.
Yes, and we have a 10 and 16-year-old as well.
Yes. And we were talking about, I'm pregnant right now, and you've been so honest.
I'm so sorry.
I know.
I'm having like PTSD right now, like looking at you.
I love that you've been so honest about it, because I talk often about how, you know, you recognize it's a blessing and a gift. It's not that.
Totally.
It's just that it's really it's not
a pain in the butt.
And it's a pain in the butt.
Everyone's different.
Yeah.
Everyone's bodies are different. Like my sister.
My mom floated through four kids. Yeah. And
My sister, you know, she handled pregnancies great. Like she always said, if you ever want to have another kid, I'll be here. We have four, so we're solid. We're a band. But like, I would never ever do it again. I honestly blamed myself the second time because I was like, you knew.
You forget though.
You did this
you
to yourself.
When you're pregnant. Like,
and I love
you
them. I don't want that to come off wrong because I know a lot of people have troubles having children, so I never want to come off as I'm not ungrateful for it, but it's just my body does not like being pregnant. I'm not meant to be pregnant.
I understand.
No.
It's not easy.
It's horrible.
It's not easy. And you notice, after you have the baby, you forget about everything that happened during the pregnancy.
You, right?
I didn't forget.
I
didn't forget. It was what happened is people said, there's no way it can be like that again. And they were all wrong.
Now, you've written a new children's book called River Rose and the Magical Christmas.
Yes.
And this is when your little girl comes into the story.
Yes. Oh.
Now, this is the second book in your series about your daughter. What does she think about having a series about her? Because I heard she's quite a little handful.
She is such a handful. She's great. She's like a little unicorn. She's awesome. But then it's just like, I mean, if you have kids, it's like, they're so sweet. And then you're like, they're just like out of nowhere. Like, they're like, and then it's like, they just get so manipulative at three. It's so scary.
Oh,
the foreshadowing is disheartening. But yeah, I'm just really scared about it. But she is really great, and she's fun, and she's really smart.
She's a star.
And she's a little star. I'm scared, Whoopi.
You should be.
I am. I know.
You should be.
She literally saw her book somewhere. We were at like Wee Day in Canada, and she was like, she saw somebody with it, they wanted me to sign it. She was like, why do you have my book? She thought like it was just hers, like there were no more.
Well, you know. Look, you can come back here anytime.
We love you.
I like coming.
Thank you, babe. Thanks to Kelly Clarkson. Members of our audience, first of all, you're going home with the new album.
Yeah.
But because you're really nice, you're also getting the kids' book. Christmas. We will be right back.